The man who murdered 13 people in the 2009 Fort Hood massacre has been sentenced to death. Today, that decision is getting mixed reactions. Many believe the death sentence is exactly what Major Nadal Hassan wanted. And while victims are relieved he is being punished, they say Nadal's deadly rampage could have been prevented.
It's a sentence 4 years in the making.
This has been a very long and exhausting process. We are tired. We are hurt. But we are resolved. Justice has been served.
The same jury that convicted Major Nadal Hassan on 13 counts of premeditated murder chose the death penalty Wednesday over life in prison without parole. Many worried that a death sentence was exactly what Hassan wanted in his quest for martyrdom. Only weeks ago, his standby defense team asked to be relieved because they felt Hassan was seeking a guilty verdict. But victims say it's a sentence they'll accept.
It was a concern of some, but I am just fine with that now because it will take a very long time for him to be executed, and it is a much stiffer punishment than life without parole.
They say it's a sentence that fits the heinousness of the crime. Among those killed, a pregnant mother who pleaded for her unborn child before Hassan killed her. Now that this phase of the victim's quest for justice is over, many are turning their attention to another issue, a civil case against the government. They say the attack should be reclassified as combat-related instead of workplace violence to make victims eligible for more medical benefits and to recognize those who fought back with military decorations. During his trial, Hassan stated that he attacked the unarmed soldiers in order to protect Muslim insurgents in Iraq and Afghanistan.
Anyone who would use their religion to commit acts of terrorism serves no god except their own hatred and self-interest.
The suit also slams the FBI. The left-wing magazine Mother Jones recently reported on FBI emails that show Hassan was on the Bureau's radar nearly a year before the Fort Hood massacre. They intercepted several emails between Hassan and Anwar al-Awlaki, a radical Islamic cleric with ties to 9/11.
He was radicalized, and I think a lot of those red flags were ignored. So, you know, in this era of extremist Islamist behavior, we have to take note of people that are making contact with those that are practicing that type of behavior.
The FBI decided against interviewing Hassan or his superiors because they didn't want their investigation into al-Awlaki to harm Hassan's career. One agent described the case as politically sensitive.
Before an execution date is set, Hassan faces years, if not decades, of appeals, whether he wants it or not. He will not be allowed to represent himself during the process.